Hello and welcome to part one of How to Rat, or Day in Life of a Rat. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to call this series yet, but it is just a basic instructional video for being a field rat. This is not to be considered your drill or the textbook. Always follow the standard operating procedures on the website. This is just a little thing that I want to make for you guys. It's also a one-take wonder, because I don't have editing software anyway. There's a rat signal. Thank you, Olivia, for being help there. I'm just gonna type. So the moment you get a signal, you type the system in. Oh, is this not a sector thingy? That is, that doesn't search. IZZ. G-H-U-B-C. Yeah, that doesn't search. Is my galaxy map being silly? Hold on. Galaxy map's not finding that, which is odd. It should, I know it should. Been to the ICC sector before. Some ICZ sector GHUP3- oh, 7. Don't typo. That might help as well. It's not the sector? Is it for that sector? There we go. Found it. Boop. Alright, so once you find it, you look at your left panel and you see there it says 5 jumps. So what you type in chat is 5J. And then obviously you are silly and open your gal map, and then you simply jump over. Charging. Dispatch, in this case, Jiriakel. Jiriakel, I can't pronounce names for things. Will give you a go, in which case you will go. However, when you call your jumps, you already want to be jumping. So when you tell dispatch 5 jumps, you actually want to already be 4 jumps in. Or rather, 4 jumps for a meaning. Dispatch just asked if the client is on emergency oxygen. If the client is, then they are to log out to the main menu, because that is where oxygen stops counting. Meanwhile, we're just going to keep jumping. Dispatch will soon enough ask if the client wants to send us a friend request. Another thing to note is when you read rat signals, ensure that you're on the right platform, so either PC or Xbox. There you go. So the squeaking you're hearing, by the way, that is somebody on the IRC saying my nickname or the word rat signal. I would highly recommend you set up a similar kind of noise, scooping, or at least some sort of noise. So the client is adding me as a friend. In the top left, you will see in your comms menu there's 5 tabs. If the middle tab starts having a number in blue,
warning, that means you temperature have the critical.
Friend request received, and you should always report this to dispatch.
Fuel scoop disengaged. Frameshift drive charging.
Ignore that, that was from the previous thing. There it is. So I want to accept it, and then in chat I'll put plus FR, meaning that plus is a positive, as in I have, and the FR is short for friend request. And the next step is, you just keep flying while you're doing this. Flying at this point should be automatic pilot. Pardon the pun. So at this point, dispatch will ask the client to send me a wing invite. And the abbreviation for wing invite can be either WR for wing request, or WI for wing invite. It's personal preference. I personally use WR because, or plus W even would work. When you have a friend invite, you should always open your galaxy map and double check that the client is in the system they reported, which it appears to be. I have my galaxy map filtered, so I can't actually see that system. And it appears that Commander Olivia is indeed in that system. So we can keep jumping. You always want to make sure that you scoop as much as possible before you enter the system.
Fuel scooping.
Because then the system might not be scoopable.
Fuel scooping complete.
Luckily this one is, so we're just gonna keep going.
Frameshift drive charging.
And there's the request for a wing. Or rather, dispatch's request to send a wing invite.
4, 3, 2, 1.
There's the thing, so I'm gonna set the plus wing request. I'm sending WR in this case because I haven't accepted the wing invite yet. Plus W is sometimes confused with that you have the wing, which I obviously don't yet. Throttle back, accept the wing invite. In system, or in sys for short. This, although looks like a scoopable, is not actually a scoopable.
Fuel scooping.
Wait.
Fuel scoop disengaged.
I lied. I'm one jump away.
Drive charging.
Oh, I'm a liar. See? We're not perfect. We make mistakes. Even somebody with many and many rescues still sometimes stuff things up, which I just had. In which case, just be concise, fix your problem, and keep going. Alright, I'm gonna throttle to zero, steer away from the star, in system now. I'm gonna send out a quick macro, just to make sure that messages are going through. These macros are optional, I have them on my keyboard because I have a special keyboard with G keys on the left. This point the client is requested to drop a wing beacon. At this point you want to be looking on the left panel and on your radar down here. If you have head look, you could do something like this. Keep an eye on both. Olivia just responded. That's not of importance. Important thing is fuel. Fuel first. Always fuel first. In real life, there is a saying that goes, aviate, then navigate, then communicate. As in, make sure you don't die, then make sure you're going the right way, and then make sure you're telling people. I will say plus B for seeing the beacon. Now, lately in 1.5, there has been some some problems where if you drop onto someone with navlock, then you will collide with them. As such, I recommend dropping in manually until this issue is resolved. And the moment you are starting to drop in, go full reverse, just in case. Wing one. Alright, and there is the client. So the moment you're in range, fire Olympidrone, and then say hello! Use your shield.
Transferring fuel.
Olympids tend to explode! At this point, while you're waiting for the client's shields to at least start recharging, you want to tell dispatch what you're doing, that you have the instance, that you're fueling. At which point, they know that the case is done. Debriefing is basically telling the people about fuel, asking them if they know about the fuel scoop. If they don't know about it, teach them about it. Ask them if they know how to filter on the galaxy map, in the way that I have, so that, as you can see, this system doesn't actually show up on my galaxy map. It's because I've filtered the top 7, because those are the scoopable stars. Since the client has their scanners turned off, they don't actually see you. So sometimes it might help to have them be to fly in front of them so that they can see you. As you can see in the bottom right, this client appears to be running by Weaves, because oh my god, that thing goes fast. Paperwork, we will. Actually, paperwork should have been covered in your drill, or will be covered in your drill once you get to it. Another good command to use in an IRC, we can't right now because we're in a testing channel. Well, Olivia's playing a silly. We're not gonna continue that. But yeah, normally you'd ask them for a fuel scoop, then you teach them about it. Usually I try to enable wing voice because I prefer explaining things over voice. That's why I'm making a video instead of writing an article. Debrief is teaching them about the fuel scoop, teaching them about how to filter, teaching them which classes are scoopable. And the paperwork is the quick Google form that you'll have to fill in real quick just to get your name on the leaderboards and update that number. I'm told that that system will be changed at some point so that you don't have to do it. But anyway, this is a simple rescue I'm going to go through with Olivia about how to get yourself a fuel scoop, how to use it. Thank you all for watching, and I will see you next time.